Back in the day, Mystikal created a series or a group of songs that people anticipated that you have not forgotten about, that I have not forgotten about. And he may call these the smoke songs. I call it the Mystikal Smokin' series, but that's what we're gonna talk about today. But first, before we get into that, if you haven't already subscribed to the channel, because I talk about these subjects all the time, and if you're returning, make sure you have that bell click so that you can be notified when I drop these videos. Like this video and hit share. We can start it off in 1994. In 1994, you had the self-titled Mystikal, which was on Big Boy Records. In 1995, that album was basically re-released on Jive Records and Big Boy as Mind of Mystikal, and it had a song on there called Smoke Something. This one go out to all the niggas who be getting loaded, all the ladies who be getting loaded. Now this started it all. You had a smoking song. It was nice and smooth, produced by DJ Precise, or simply Precise, or Sice. At that point, nobody would know that this would become a series or just become one of those classic tracks, but it was really one of those great songs on the album. Well, every song on that album goes hard. That's one of those few albums where you can listen to from the beginning to the end, I say. But what I do remember, because I probably was about just getting into teenagehood around that time, and I remember hearing that part where it slowed down and we was like kids talking about, oh, they screwed it. Niggas be moving in slow motion, smoking a bionic crown. So that's Smoke Something. In 1997, you have what we may consider the first Mystikal album on No Limit Records, which was called Unpredictable. The smoke song on this one is called Still Smoking, and it was produced by the legendary Traxster. On the first one, you did have that humming, but they replaced that with words on this second version. This track, I really don't like as much because I do like the more raw sound of the first one. This is one of those rare cases where I really do like the, not muddiness, but the kind of muddiness and the raw underground nature of an earlier version. We kind of got a story out of Mystikal on this one, and at the end, he was basically arrested. But then, he's right back, still smoking. Straight from jail to the weed spot. Should I take that as a minor setback? Hell no, I ain't stop. In 1998, you had Ghetto Fabulous, and the song is I smell smoke. I'll just say that this one is my favorite because at this point, you had those first two, but I think the third one really took it up to another level in terms of the lyrics, the delivery, all that, and of course that beat produced by Odell. So that riff that was done with vocals on the first one and then it with actual singing lyrics on that second one has become a guitar riff in a wong-wong guitar. And then you have those strings added, and this version is a lot more mellow and soulful and smooth for people who like that ambiance when they smoking. So that first version was 2 minutes and 7 seconds. The second version is 2 minutes and 27 seconds. By the time we get to the third one, we got 3 minutes and 29 seconds. And that first minute of this is an intro, so you get to just feel that smooth beat before Mystikal drops his verse, because as you know, there weren't any hooks. It was just a straight flow on all of these. And I especially love the way that he started the verse too, just that style and cadence. Bring it up, chop it up, cut it up, cut the end, take the fill out, roll it up, light, hit it, hold it fast, pop up, blow it up. And this is another one of those storytelling versions of this song. And at the end, like in the previous version, he took a loss. And what's really funny is he took a loss because of what happened sort of in that second version where he did get arrested and it wasn't really, you know, the cops. In 2000, you had the album Let's Get Ready with the song Smoked Out. We about to get smoked out, this bitch tonight. This version could possibly be my least favorite, probably just because of the beat. Now, it was a lot more bass heavy. Odell produced it and kept those strings in there. But all of the instruments are a lot more electronic instruments in this version of the song. This one is even longer, 3 minutes and 57 seconds, and I do think that the tempo is faster. Mystikal on it didn't really give us another story, which at the time kind of disappointed me. But he did make reference to the other Smoke songs, because now this is clearly a series, an event that we look forward to. Three Smoke songs and two recharge, you know the credentials. I mean, it's all Smoke songs. I got so good, I forgot to count this. And it's clear that everybody expected one of these songs on this album in 2000. If you made it this far in the video, I just say you might as well go ahead, hit subscribe because you do like this content, and hit the thumbs up button because obviously you like this video enough to continue watching. So go ahead and do that to help support this channel and we can keep pushing what we have going on here forward. Tarantula came out in 2001 and it's our last Mystikal album, right? I don't know, y'all, I'm getting old. Let me know, is that the last Mystikal album? But the song on there is called Smoke One. Smoke One, nigga. Nigga, hit the motherfucking weed, bro. This one, again, was also produced by Odell. And that intro has gotten a lot longer. It's like almost 2 minutes before Mystikal even spits a bar, sort of. Put the fire to it, put it in the wind. Forget about how you roll. Because this one kind of have a hook on it that plays at the beginning and at the end. So I do kind of consider that a hook. And the beat kind of have that little reggae sound. Is it like a reggae lick, or can I consider that a guitar lick? I don't know. It's not really like a riff. It's kind of just, you know what I'm talking about. I did like the part where he's talking about it's not in how you roll it, you know, it's really just a Smokin song. Don't worry about how the bitch look. It got a hole in the stick broken out. There ain't nothing past that bitch. Put your finger over and hit it with your mouth. And by the time we get to this version, we've gotten up to 4 minutes and 23 seconds. So it actually did get longer and longer as time went on. And another thing that I did notice was you had that first version where you take elements, you had the that part, and then you got into the singing of that, and then you got into the guitar part, into this version where it's kind of already changed, but it has evolved. So we don't really pull from that first version. This is like an original version in itself, and I think that's really great to do, where you can extend something and basically taking pieces that you keep adding in, and you have those other parts that kind of just fade out, kind of, you know, you just kind of say, yeah, we're not gonna do that anymore as the evolution of this series. Now, I hope we do get another version. I hope we get a new Mystikal album. And if we do get a Mystikal album, it better have a Smoke song on it, because we have come to expect that. And I wonder what it would sound like in this day and age, or whenever Mystikal gets around to dropping another album. All right, tell me what you think about these Smoke songs. What's your favorite? Which one did you jam the most? Which one had the best beat? Which one had the best lyrics? All of those little things, let me know. Do you think we're gonna get another Mystikal album? You think we're gonna get at least another Smoke song from Mystikal? Thank you for watching. Don't forget to subscribe. Click the bell so you can be notified. Sign up for my mailing list down below. If you didn't know, I do have a Spotify playlist that I add all of these songs that I talk about. The link for that can be found in the description of all my videos. So go ahead and check out my Spotify playlist where I add these songs that we talk about. And we have over 100 now, and we're still continuing to build, because every time a new video come out, the Spotify playlist is updated. Go ahead and follow that playlist on Spotify. Check out my website. I have links to all my social media accounts, so you can follow me on Instagram and on Twitter. You can check out music videos from the artists we love. Let me know if I should put like some release dates and stuff up there. I'm gonna have some other interactive things on the site as well. And you can also go there and check out my previous videos, so you don't have to scroll through YouTube and all that. But you can find my videos on my website, heitmusic.com. It's been great. It's Heit. Catch you on the B-side.